Welcome! This movie demonstrates the use of PDS-2000 views in a BlueView sonar project. It is also shown how to log data, importing BlueView sonar files, and replay PDS log files. See also the movie Setting up PDS-2000 for BlueView sonar, and the movie Defining a PDS-2000 screen layout for a BlueView forward-looking sonar. Before we start the movie, there is an important amendment notification to be made. In this movie, the obstacle avoidance view is used. However, from PDS-2000 version 3.9.2.3, the obstacle avoidance view is replaced by the sonar wedge view. The behavior of this view is exactly the same. When the screen layout is defined, and the views are also defined with the correct layers and its properties, it is time to operate. We have our configuration view, on which we can control our sonar. The numeric standard view, displaying numerical data. Our plan view and our 3D view online. And the obstacle avoidance forward-looking views. Change the contrast of the forward-looking view by clicking the contrast icons. The contrast changes. Same for example for the gamma settings. We can do measurements. Take a snapshot. And also a nice feature when you have more forward-looking views. You can zoom in one of the views, while the other one still shows the complete overview. Click the zoom extends icon to get the original size back. Also in the plan view navigation, different functions are available, like the measurement function. Or you could create sonar targets. Click the icon. Drag a box around your target. And automatically your target is displayed with its information. The target's location is indicated in the plan view. You can add a target information view if needed. So now we have a target information view. When you click on an existing target location, the associated information will be displayed. You can also delete a target. There are many other functions available. I will not discuss them all. Of course, you can also log your data in PDS-2000. One way to start logging is to click on the Log button on the right lower corner. When the button is red colored, it means logging is off. When it is green colored, it means logging is on. Click the logging icon to see your logging settings. The PDS2000 format is always logged. Be aware your BlueView sonar data, like your image, is only logged when it is enabled in your device properties. When I check these properties, the data logging should be enabled. By default, the data logging is enabled. Same for the BlueView configuration data. When I select in the BlueView configuration view data recording, I can also log the sonar data. Remember, this only logs sonar wedge data used by the BlueView Pro Viewer software. It does not include positioning, attitude and heading information. Therefore, always use the PDS2000 logging to log PDS log files. You can also synchronize this logging with the PDS2000 logging. When the PDS2000 logging starts, also the sonar logging will start. The sonar files have the extension SON. Logged files are accessible by the log data file in the PDS2000 Control Center Explorer. We see our PDS2000 log files or the BlueView sonar files. When you have a sonar file recorded with the BlueView Pro Viewer software, you can still replay or edit such a file in PDS2000. Such a file needs first to be converted into a PDS file by the import tool. Click the import icon. Click the file type you like to import. So in this case the BlueView SON files. Click add. Select the file. And click import. If the sonar file has included the offsets for the position, attitude and multibeam, etc., then they are listed in this display. If all the values are zero, then the sonar file didn't include the offsets and the surveyor can set them here as well. When the sonar data needed to be linked to the real world, it should have been recorded with positioning, heading and attitude data. The sonar file has been imported successfully and now also a PDS file is available. course, when PDS was used to record data, a import is not needed, as these files are already PDS files. PDS files can be replayed. Click the replay button. First, a file set needs to be created with all the files you like to replay. Click New to create a new file set or select a existing file set. Give the file set a name. Select the files to be replayed. And the replayer starts. You can add views the same way as you did in the acquisition. Click the play button to start the replay.
Teledyne RESON, everywhere you look.